Hello, 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 everyone. We are here with this year's Spring Wonderhobby podcast. And joining me today is Tech. Elira. Well,
hi, you can call me Elia.
Elia, yes. Hey, Ray.
New thing I'm trying.
And we sadly do not have a reactive ping for Kata, so he would just have to go by voice. So, Kata?
Hi, I'm Scrapkin Kata, or Kata for short. I'm just an indie streamer on Scrapkin Kata.
And you guys already know me. It's Oh My God, I'm on Fire, or Fire for short. I continually regret having a fucking mouthful name, but it is what it is. So, Spring Wonderhobby Festival. I expected to have our backs blown out like we have been for the past few podcasts, but it's pretty light this time.
This is downright anemic.
It is anemic. So
I was able to look through all this in like less than an hour.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, I thought that was gonna take me forever.
Yeah. So what do you guys want to start off with? We got the scale figures, the Nendroids, the Figma, the pop-up parade, and the others.
Do we just want to get the elephant out of the room and talk about Arcuade?
You know what? Let's start off with fucking Arcuade right here. Fucking
first thing in my notes.
Fucking Arcuade here. On a glance, this looks like a perfectly acceptable figure. Then you start looking at it deeper. And looking at the jointing. And you're like, bruh, what the fuck you doing, Figma?
If you told me this thing was from like 2001, I'd fucking believe you.
Yeah, it ain't great.
It's perfectly in character for Ark, because her whole thing is that she's like 10 years out of dates.
Oh, God, yeah. Oh, God, yeah. So the thing that gets me most about this is... Wrong. The thing that gets me most about this is the fucking torso joint. I could accept the jank thigh cut. I could accept the honestly out-of-place double-jointed knees. I don't think they look great. I don't think the thigh cut is really any better than the thigh cuts the previous way they've done thigh swivels before. But it's the ab crunch. That's just ugly. That is fucking Marvel Legends tier engineering.
Given Figma's like historic usage of like a soft PVC over like a really long torso joint extending into like the hips and waist area, it fucking boggles my mind. Have they ever done anything like this?
They've been doing this more often. Inosuke from Demon Slayer has the same exact type of torso joint.
He's shirtless!
Yeah, I know. There's some other... There's like at least two others I can think of that have it.
Oh, does their Bruce Lee have it?
No, their Bruce Lee does not have it.
That's shocking.
I mean, their Bruce Lee is... Okay. Audio quiet. Okay.
Is that
better?
I'm leaning a little bit away from my mic.
Okay. Do you have anything you want to repeat that spiel, Tech, or Elira, fucking God,
Elia. It's okay. I know it's a new thing.
Wow. No, Libra. No, it's Elira Pandora of Niji Sanji.
I wish I had someone that famous on here. No offense.
No, it's okay. I know. It's just so, it's so wild to me that they've done like bodies like this before and have a solution for this and then just decided to do this.
The engine, yeah, go on.
I just don't get it. And like, I'm looking at Inosuke, and even Inosuke looks better than this, if only because it follows the shape of his abs. It doesn't look great, but like, there's something there that makes sense and doesn't just look like a toy girl.
Now, the thing that gets me most about this is... This would be acceptable in Figma's early stages. This is when they've become relatively competent as a, well, they're kind of incompetent these days. It's back when they were like, you know, it's in the modern day of Figma. So you'd think they'd not do that stuff, but yeah, Figma's gonna be a thorough line throughout this entire podcast because they're doing some dumbass fucking shit. Speaking of dumbass fucking shit, if we're done with Arcade here, is there anything else you guys want to add?
Every single time I look at this arc, I'm just kind of baffled that this is something that was made in 2023. Because as we already said, this looks really outdated.
Yeah. Hell, the arcs. Oh, go on.
Go on. Oh, no, it's just that the whole torso joint, it reminds me of that. I know this is a completely different case. It reminds me of that Uma Musume one of Tokai Teo, the one with like the exploding torso.
Oh, that thing. Is that a model kit?
It was a model kit. That's why it looked weird.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not great. But it's kind of sad that the Figma released of Arc in her magical girl outfit in like, what, 2015 or whenever the fuck it came out, looks better than this.
Marble Phantasmoon from Carnival Phantasm.
Yes. So next up is the continuing lack of drip that Juju Kaisen has. Literally the most boring character designs, and I don't know how this fucking series keeps on getting Figmas when there's so many more interesting character designs you could be making figures of.
It's popular.
It's a popular show. And I like this character's design for what it's worth, but they are hiding the thing that makes it an interesting design, which he has a really fucked up mouth.
Yeah, his mouth is dope. I don't remember what the fuck his name is, but I've seen like the like one really cool fight scene with him. And I'm like, yo. I hope that once they reveal like a colored prototype, they'll reveal like an alternate like a muffler head piece.
Okay.
And have like the head with like the cool tattoos and shit.
Yeah, his name would be Toge Inumaki, because his whole gimmick is like he can't speak properly because his words are curses. Mm-hmm. He forces people to do whatever he says.
Mm.
So instead, he talks in like weird homonyms of like onigiri dressings.
I would say he doesn't. He just say like ingredients for onigiri.
That's silly. Ray brings up the fact that Ark should come with a long skirt and. Yeah, probably would be better.
Is the skirt the main thing?
Yeah, the granny dress is her old design, and I joked about this and will always joke about it, but giving her a mini skirt in the remake, when they first revealed it, it was way too trendy. But then it took like 10 years between that reveal and the game to come out, so much like Ark herself, it's 10 years out of date again.
Yeah, moving on, we've got another Umasume pretty derby girl, and this looks good. What was that?
That's nice nature, and I know a lot of people who are losing their shit over her because she is one of the most popular in my friend groups because she looks like the main girl from Euphonium.
Yeah, I was about to say, that's what I reminded
her. She does, you're right, yeah.
Kumiko? Yes. This looks good, the skirts. I mean, there's not much you can do about that to get articulation, so splitting it up like this is acceptable.
She doesn't have a particular or a fluffy skirt in the game itself, so this is fine.
Yeah. I expect this to come out in 2025. That's going to be another thing that goes along with Figma these days, is long wait times. So moving up, we have an original character design from Return to Human Figma NH02. Another doll girl. I really like this. I really like how this looks.
I almost put a note down about how into this design I am, but I was like, I'll leave it in unless we like just talk about it casually. This design's super good.
This design is great.
To be a bit of a downer, this gives me Sino Alice reject vibes.
You're right.
I like Sino Alice, even like the reject vibes though.
Yeah,
I know. But I don't mind Sino Alice, but it kind of came off as one of those gacha games that was like trying too hard to be counterculture.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, I think we all have a little bit of resentment towards it because fucking it killing Civil Gear XDU in America.
Wait, what? Really?
Kind of. It was a horrible case of mismanagement, and Sino Alice got pushed way harder, and that was the game that actually had the means to stand on its own legs as opposed to Civil Gear XDU or Magireko.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Magireko did a bit better and even got its own server unique character, Ashley Taylor, who is an American who has the game's equivalent of an FGO character having 4 Buster cards.
So Ray brings up that was it Ray or Warthog? Warthog brings up that this gal has Kotoki legs, and he's not entirely wrong.
Kotoki,
as in the mecha designer for NH02.
Okay. Kotoki.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. He's known for having his mecha having very long legs.
Ah.
Oh, this is the guy who did 8 Star Story?
Or is that... No, that's a different guy. He's done, like, tons of Gundam designs. You would probably know him best for the GPO line of Mecha from Stardust Memory.
Oh, that makes sense.
So next up is a girl from Alistair Ages, Blue Sky. So what I've heard, and I'm not entirely sure about this, I just saw it mentioned on some threads. Sentinel, or 1000 Toys, or whatever the fuck they're going by nowadays, they're apparently helping Max Factory on this with the armor pieces, which is an interesting collab. But the Alistair Ages girls apparently have been having quality issues. Ray can testament to that in chat.
I keep forgetting this series is designed by the person who did the art for Strike Witches.
Oh, that makes sense. That explains that the does. Like, legs and like kind
of
like the.
Well,
like,
a lot of Mecha Musume stuff has his hand has Fumikage's. I don't know. Has their hand in it. Like fucking Frame Arms Girls has their hand in it. Megami Device had some hand in it. 30 Minute Sisters. Basically, if it's a Mecha Musume property, at one even point or another, they've had their hand in it.
Even FGO has that artist working on it to a degree.
So, we are getting to the Lyricos Ryoko Figmas. And this is going to go into a wider discussion about some other stuff. So, we're going to tangent a little bit before we get to... Actually, let's get Thorfinn out of the way before we go into the Lyricos Ryoko girls. Figma Thorfinn, motherfucker's wearing a fucking potato burlap sack.
Wild to me that they're willing to go with soft goods and yet they can't fucking render Arcade's fucking sweater.
Yeah. Now, I don't think this entire looks awful, but here's the thing. This figure, Figma, was revealed about 2 to 3 years ago and is only now getting to the finalized prototype stage. Does this dude even look like how he does now in the current season of the anime?
Kind of. It's like there's like a, I want to say, 7 year gap between when the first season ends when Farmland Saga starts. But we do get regular flashbacks to his past.
So this is not entirely irrelevant.
No, it's definitely not. Okay. But I love the fact that they actually did give him the soft goods, because it really does add to that whole, like, murder hobo vibe he always had as a kid.
So Warthog brings up, in regards to the Alistair Ages Figma, Sentinel and Figma teaming up is a price made in price gouging hell. Oh, don't fucking tell me about it. And Ray brings up, Sentinel does high-ender figures, and they're pretty expensive. I mean, they're good most of the time, but, like, they're pretty expensive. And Ray brings up the prototype clothes on this guy were better. I wouldn't know. I don't remember what the prototype looks like for this guy.
Here, let me see if I can grab the photo of it real quick.
Yeah, bring that. And we're just gonna sit on fucking the Lyricos Ryoko girl for a second.
Oh, yeah. Oh, those are rendered seemingly soft plastic almost.
I'll drop it in the Discord.
Yeah, drop it in the Discord. I'm gonna look it up on there. Open a browser.
Like, the sizing looks way better.
Holy shit, you guys aren't kidding. That looks 1,000 times better than what they got now. Like,
this is a downgrade, but even if I don't like the finalized version, that is a downgrade.
Yeah, that's...
I mean, like, soft goods are hard to do, but, like, how do you get it right the
first time and then fuck it up later?
Maybe it's probably the type of a fabric they had to use to get the color? I don't know.
Yeah, it's
really
bad.
Weird.
It's a downgrade.
I had to deal with a lot when I was doing Warhammer 40K when I was younger, so that makes sense.
So, we're going to move on from Thorfinn and getting into a wider discussion about the state of the Figma line. It's the Lyricos Ryoko girls! Coming about a year too late from the show finishing up.
But to be fair, they have a second season
They do
coming
have
out.
A season coming out, yes, yes. But, you know, these look good. These look good. You guys have anything to add?
Yeah, to spoil something, whichever one's cheaper and comes with guns, because I can very much see Figma being like, we'll give them handguns and that's it.
There's another factor.
Just be like, hey, buy a little armory.
There's another factor to it, though. So you see those skirts? They're hard. They're going to be hard or rubber plastic, restricting articulation. Yep. And I have not watched Lyricos Ryoko, But I do know that it is a very much an action show with them doing crazy stunts. So give me a second to pull up
the important thing is right if page. It's hard plastic, we can't just get that one shot of Chisato?
Yeah, Chisato upside down.
With the handstand.
Also, before we move on to this, why the fuck are her thighs looking so thin? Like, the only thing I really know about Chisato is her thighs are absurdly thick.
I think, I really feel like, it's been a while since I've watched the show and I still haven't finished it, but I feel like they really exaggerated her thighs for that one particular shot. I don't ever remember them being that big.
Also, it is a stitch sequence in the immediate previous cuts of the show. They do not look that thick. Okay. So it's a weird perspective trick. And the stitch is doing too good.
That's disappointing.
They are still pretty thick, but more in a sort of like athletic kind of way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Ray brings up that Chisato only uses one gun, so.
Yeah, but I can still really see fucking some cheaping out of accessories somehow.
And that brings us to, so if you don't know, BuzzMod is a competing, I say competing, is a competing 1/12 articulated figure line that does a lot of soft goods with their figures. And they're also doing Lyricose Ryoko figures. And the thing is, Aniplex, I'm assuming, is the main licensor for the show. Aniplex owns A1 Pictures, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so not only are they competing, they're competing against themselves now. So I'm curious as to why they even gave Figma the license to begin with if they were going to do these from their own toy line.
That's not too uncommon in the world of business. There's a lot of stores that are owned by the same parent company that will open up right beside each other.
Yeah.
The idea is that it pushes a higher quality of service, or in this case, production. So potentially BuzzMod might produce the better products. And as a result, this means that either Figma is going to have to produce better results to keep their contracts, or they are going to get out bid by BuzzMod or other
people. Well, here's the thing. BuzzMod is made by Aniplex. It's literally just internal production.
But if they're going to... if they're just going to have BuzzMod do it, why go through Figma if they can just do it internal?
Yeah.
My immediate suspicion is maybe that like there are some people, myself included, who are often turned off by soft goods. So this is a way to cast a net in like both directions.
That's also like said, I think, I'll be honest, I think the BuzzMods would be better just because the range of motion. Oh, hey, Jay! What's up, Jay? What's up, Jay? How's it going? I'm about to take my second shot of the night. But this is also like a wider net into the health of Figma as a whole. So you got them, you got Aniplex just giving them the license as well, even though they're going to be doing the same thing. BuzzMods, I think I'm just going to think, like, if I buy any of these or get around to watching it so I can justify buying this, I think I'm just going to go for the BuzzMod because the skirt being wired and movable is better than having to deal with a plastic skirt. But also, people are saying that Figma has lost the license to do Fate Grand or Fate stuff in general. I'm not sure where that started. I just saw a bunch of people saying that
anything announced for so long that it's become a popular rumor, but because I don't keep my head to the ground with figure news like you guys, that might just be baseless speculation.
Yeah, I'm thinking it's baseless speculation, but it is very weird that they haven't announced anything Fate when it's been like one of their main sublines in Figma.
It would be interesting if they basically did lose the licenses.
Yeah.
And they all start being handled internally.
But I'm going to move over to the other thing is Bocchi the Rock is currently one of the most popular anime right now. You'd think Figma would be doing something for them. Turns out, no, it's BuzzMod. We're getting an articulated Bocchi Figma from BuzzMod. And knowing BuzzMod's commitment to doing most of the casts of the shows they've done, if you look at fucking Demon Slayer, they've done literally every Demon Slayer character and the villains, which is rare.
Incredible.
We're likely going to get a full band of 1/12 scale Bocchi figures from BuzzMod. And I'm very excited for that. Like, I'm very, very excited for that.
Look, the best thing toy you can make for Bocchi herself would be to make one out of soft rubber so you can squish it and to simulate the anxiety attacks. And then like Stretch Armstrong or his antagonist, Vac-Man, it snaps back into place.
Fucking Vac-Man. I'm just reminded of we can't bring up Stretch Armstrong videos because we will start watching Stretch Armstrong destruction videos. So we gotta put a pin on that conversation. Bocchi with a gun. Hey, listen, I've got plenty of 112 scale guns. Bocchi, I will give Bocchi a gun.
Bocchi the Glock.
Bocchi the Glock. Ray brings up bringing back to the Figma stuff for Fate. They haven't done a normal MH Mysterious Heroine X or a Castoria, which is... Oh, wow, we just had a power surge blink here.
Oh, all right.
Oh, that's not good.
No, that's no good. It's probably just... Nope.
I have stream up on my top monitor. If it goes off, I'll let you know.
I'm going to turn off some lights. Maybe I'm running too much power. I don't know.
Maybe.
So, it is what it is. But
Jack
should be made of cloth so you can reveal her power underneath. I saw people talking about this on 4chan's toy board, and I'm like, yeah, they should do that. But yeah, I'm very excited for this. I hope we get all four members, and I hope we also get a Kikuri as well to go with it.
I buy a Kikuri. But, I haven't seen Bocchi, but I love Kikuri.
Everyone loves Kikuri. But yeah, that's the state of Figma. It's pretty fucking dire. Like,
it's pretty bare.
It's pretty bare. We've got baffling decisions in terms of articulation. We have other figure lines catching up and doing just as good, if not better, work.
And no placards, even.
No placards. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
But that also brings up, so Niki, the ash shooting game, is currently one of the hot things that's going on. You'd think Figma would...
Wanting to talk about that.
You would think Figma would capitalize it, but instead, one of Goodsmile Company's subsidiaries, Goodsmile Company Shanghai, is doing Nikkei figures for their new articulated line called Hyperbody.
Oh. Now, this Hyperbody is stationed in Shanghai, correct?
Yes, and Nikkei is Chinese. I think you were going to bring up that point.
I think it's actually the studio is in Shanghai.
So I guess it makes sense that part, but you know, Figma's done Chinese properties before. They've done Western properties, so it wouldn't be out of line for them to do something like this. But I think it's also a statement as to
Figma's brand strength.
Figma's brand strength now that they went for a different figure line. It's also probably another reason why the Simfigure figures didn't come out as Figma's. They came out as Act Modes, because Act Modes and they don't have model kit bits really besides the stands. So
I have to say though, since we're on Nikki right here, I gotta say I've played like a relatively reasonable bit of Nikkei. I don't know who the fuck this is.
I don't know who this is either.
He was a popular event character from like the second or third events of the game.
Oh, huh.
From what I understand. But from what I can get, I'm surprised they went with her instead of like the girl that has a Sawano soundtrack to her?
I'll be honest. I only remember two Nikki characters off the top of three Nikki characters off the top of my head. It's the yellow girl, the yellow haired girl with shorts, the pink haired bodysuit girl, and Volume.
Ruby, then it's Alice, then Alice, Volume.
Yeah. Wait, Rappy? R-A-P-I?
No, Rupee, as in Rupee. The money in Zelda.
Second shot.
Hold on. Google thinks I'm fucking fake. Okay, let's see.
Google thinks you're fake? What does that even mean?
Oh, I have this girl, actually.
Laplace is the girl who I'm surprised they didn't make a Hyperbody for. Would
you say? Spell that for me?
Laplace, as in... I posted it.
I'm going to pull it up in...
Oh, that's a cute design. Yeah, I'm also surprised.
The song is literally composed by Hiroyuki Sawano.
Wow, thanks for the fucking alarm thing. I'm not working today. I don't need the alarm to wake me up. Oh, this design's good. I'm surprised they gave it. Okay, so whenever I see a Niki coat with like a long coat or whatever that covers up their backside, I'm like, isn't that defeating the point of this game?
I love the fucking meltdown people had over Makima having the coat in the fucking Chainsaw Man crossover, and then like a week later, like, oh, you can take the coat off.
Well, I actually agree with it, but not because, oh my god, they're covering her ass. I agree because every single time they animate a jacket or something covering the back, it looks like shit.
Yeah, fair also.
So, I'm just gonna bring up some stuff in chat. Had it not been for MHX Alter or the Lyricos Recall deal, Latoria would have been your last Figma. Dude, I think I have some Figma pre-ordered out until like the very end of this year, but I don't know what else I'm really gonna pick up from that line. Like, I might, if they finish the Ruby crew, I might pick up them, because I got a Ruby and Weiss on pre-order, but yeah, it's dire. It is really dire for that line.
I gotta shout out Warthog here, because fucking Bondrude is a fucking OG. That dude fucking rules. That Figma
is pretty good. Excellent. It's even got LEDs.
Oh, apparently Modernia isn't an event. She is main story.
Oh, did I meet her? Because I played a bit of the main story.
Chapter 6, apparently.
Oh, wait. I do know what figures I'm getting after, like, this year. I'm going to get the Hololive EN girls. I'm surprised they didn't show any updates on them.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah, they really...
Yeah.
I'd need to pop into Nikkei to see if I got to Modernia or not. So I was bad at that game.
So while we're here, we're going to look at how fucking creepy this Kaguya is.
Yeah, not a fan, I'll admit.
I mean, I will say it's probably fine for people who are into more doll aesthetics. And, like, I am a certified doll fucker as a fan of the auto scores, but,
I think this sort of, like, Nendoroid look being as creepy kind of fits the story that Kaguya ended up becoming. But it does look weird as a product.
So,
I follow a lot of, like, doll people on, like, TikTok and stuff. And the aesthetic of this is so, like, non-congruent with those kinds of dolls. And I'm like, I don't know who this is for, but I'm sure there's a community somewhere that loves this.
Yeah.
Jay says this is an appropriate design.
Yeah.
And Ray says that it is a thing that people are into. So, you know, I have no hate against it. I probably could get into it if I spend enough time around it. But as it is, I don't really.
It's a weird look for a commercial product more than anything.
Yeah. So do you guys want to move on to scale figures or pop-up parade?
Let me see what I have more notes on.
Okay.
Let's see. Nendoroid. I think that might also be an Nendoroid. Sorry, I'm like reading through here. I'm like,
That's... You're the only one that actually had
that's a Nendoroid?
Notes. I just kind of just like winged it and opened up tabs for what I wanted to talk about, which we actually got through some of those.
I've got 4 Nendoroids in my notes, and that's it.
Okay, so let's get out the fucking Nendoroids, because there's always tons of those. So let's get up the Hatsune Miku corner. We have Hatsune Miku, happy 16th birthday version.
I think that's a little bit behind. I think she's 18 now.
Wow, this has been in the pipes for a while, and it's not even done yet.
I can't believe Hatsune Miku is finally legal.
When was Hudson? Okay, no, she would be 16 this year. Never mind.
That stopped anyone from doing lewds.
Well, now her real world age matches her character age.
Finally.
There's a million.
But yeah, this looks nice.
The scale figure version of this design looks better.
We'll get to that in a bit. We have the Ryza Miku. Which I'm surprised they didn't show up a Figma for this. The Racing Miku. I just said Ryza because that's the artist.
Oh, okay.
And it really shows.
Yeah, you can tell by the thighs.
I'm not a big fan of this Racing Miku, but it's fine.
I think it will look better as a Figma, but I don't know if Figma would be able to handle one. Wait, they did a Ryza Figma, so never mind. They'll be able to handle the thighs.
And then we have the 22 one on pre-order. It's been fucking delayed for 2 months.
Yeah. And then we got the cinema roll Hatsune Miku, which is really fucking cute. I don't really buy Nendoroids, but I am tempted by this.
I have a note about this one, actually.
Okay, go.
I'm fucking pissed. I'm so angry.
Oh?
Because my favorite thing about the Miku cinema roll crossover was the fucking hairstyle, and it's just not here.
Oh.
the hairstyle, the fucking, it was like looped, it was like looped double buns, I think. Or like, let me see what this was.
Yeah, you're gonna have to show an image because I'm not familiar with it.
It was like a bow, on top.
Mm.
It's so fucking cute. And the fact that it's not here is like so disheartening.
That's a little bit disappointing.
A bit of fan art of it, but apparently it's they would change between the hairstyles in the promotion.
So she might come with an alternate head, but
if they do, I'll get it. But like that fucking,
I still think this looks cute as fuck, though.
I mean, the face and stuff is really cute, but I'm so disappointed that they're not showing off that bow hairstyle if it is gonna be there.
So
that's so iconic and cute.
So we're gonna move on to the next Nendoroid, which is a Fate one. So that's why I'm bringing it up. Nendoroid Lancer Melusheed. I don't know who the fuck this is. She's got punch
Nendoroid
gauntlets.
Lancer or Fairy Knight Lancer or Fairy Knight Lancelot. She is going to drop in FGO North America in about a week and a half.
Oh, so it's very timely.
She is one of the in-game strongest characters they've ever released as far as damage goes. And her whole thing
Oh my god. Rey is like, Melusine, my cute ghastly dragon girl Figma. Fuck you, Max Factory.
Yeah, no, that's exactly it. Melusine was tricked into adopting the name of Lancelot, and then she met the real Lancelot and was like terrified and humiliated by what a shameless womanizer he is in Fate. When you inform her that you're going to be busy in your my room dialogue, she says, oh, so if I destroy all of Caldea, then you will have time for me? Okay.
Amazing.
Cute.
Oh, a month. Okay. Yeah, Shroob has it. Hey, Shroob, how are you doing?
So. Yeah, this looks nice.
And I'm so glad they went with this outfit, but I really hope they have her visor, because she does have a cool little almost Metal Gear Rising visor thing.
Oh, where it slaps on in front of her. So
yeah, hold on. Let me see if I can.
While you wait for that, we'll bring up fucking Miss Show My Organs on stream from an X-ray.
Oh yes,
yeah, 1 year anniversary, girl.
Has it been a fucking year?
It's been a year since her debut, and she
in her colon.
And she has slowly been upgrading her bedroom to be more Ojo-sama-like.
Oh, in real life? Good for her.
Both in real life and in her streams. Like, the whole gimmick is that every 100,000 subs, she'd add a more princess-like decoration to her, like, chat room.
Oh, that's dope.
So yeah, this visor does look pretty cool.
Yeah, and they better give us a prop with the organs, the colon.
They better. I mean, that's like iconic. So we're moving on to some Demon Slayer. I don't know who the fuck this is.
Let's see. Waiting for it to show up on stream. Oh, this is one of the Hashira. He's the one I know the least about.
Okay.
He's kind of spacey.
I like his eyes, but that's about it. And then we got the Nendoroid doll Tanjiro in a, you know, nice looking thing.
That's the training outfit or the selection outfit.
Yeah, okay. Before he becomes an official Demon Slayer.
So
it looks much like someone was trying to copy the Shinsengumi look or stylize it, and I don't quite like it.
Oh, fair enough.
So we're going to bring up Nendoroid Gabimaru, aka the biggest wife guy to exist.
Oh, Gabimaru the guy.
I've only watched the first episode of this. I need to get around to the rest of it, but I fucking love this dude already. I have nothing to live for.
I just keep thinking to Bleach, and not because of the Hollow reference, but because the joke with Renji was every single time someone would, in a filler episode, would take Zabimaru away, they'd always get the name wrong to piss him off.
Yeah. Remembering something, I'm assuming either Salome or the Lancelot had a Warframe-looking figure. I don't know what that...
I'm assuming that's probably Salome, or not Salome, Lancelot.
And also Asamaru Sagiri, who's the secondary protagonist, who I don't know much about because I have not got past episode one. But, okay, is there any other specific Nendoroids we want to bring up? Because there's a lot, as always.
Not as far as the actual ones that are printed aside. Wait, no, there was one. This one from, just because I'm baffled that they have a, like, something to show already, and when the show is just airing. Mitama from Kamisama Activities in the Godless World, or the cult anime?
Hold on, it didn't pop. The link didn't work on the thing.
The girl who has, like, the hair from, like, Sayano Uta.
Yeah.
Okay.
She looks like Sayano Uta Reject.
Yeah, she does look like Sayano Uta.
But I am baffled that she is getting a figure already, or in Nendo, because that show is this season.
I thought that show was doing bad, because that's the show that has the fucking photoshopped farming sequences, right?
That's that show!
Just to be clear, that is almost 100% intentional.
Yeah, it's obviously a shit post. I don't know why people were mad about it. I'm like, obviously, this is a shit post.
Because a lot of other elements of the show are actually just, like, really bad visual direction. So this is probably what a lot of people are thinking is another example of that. Like, there is some really bad CGI almost on the level of that one anime. The one that's, like, better Shield Hero, but also it looks way worse.
that's not very descriptive. I'm gonna bring up Rebecca here for a second, because where's my fucking Arasaka dude to smash her like a pancake?
Oh, Adam Smasher.
Adam Smasher, yeah. Where's the Adam Smasher Nendoroid so we can have fucking pancake Rebecca?
You know, gotta come with the flathead alternate.
Learning about the fact that Adam Smasher in the actual Cyberpunk board game, or the tabletop, is supposed to be like a campaign-ending NPC is wild, because he's a major joke in the actual video game.
I've never played the video game, so I didn't know. But I love the fact that he just like he's not even intentionally go aiming for you. He just falls down and smashes her. It's the most tragic death ever, but like it's also hilarious.
Yeah, it is. Adam Smasher is such a cool guy, except in the actual video game.
That's funny.
Yeah. The video game's kind of a weird amalgam of disappointment in that way. But yeah. I heard it got better.
It got better. So let's bring up the fucking... Do you want to bring up the fucking Overwatch and Android, since I know you and your wife are into Overwatch?
Believe it or not, no. I don't give a shit about those. I didn't even realize, or I realized Kiriko was getting one, but I didn't care enough to say something.
Okay.
The notes that I have are, mind telling me what you're doing in the Goodsmile showcase.
Okay, we'll get to that in a bit. Because I do want to mention, like, hey, it's nice that the V-Shoujo girls are getting fucking more Nendoroids.
It is very nice that the V-Shoujo JP members are getting them. Rip to V-Shoujo for getting the fucking Nendos for members that fucking left.
Members that left because honestly, apparently their contracts were like probably like, hey, don't be a fucking dirtbag, and they're like, no, we're gonna be dirtbags.
Yeah, no, I thought they might have left because of money, but now I'm like,
creative freedoms that made them leave.
Okay, so to be clear, on at least in the case of Vay, she left because almost certainly a conflict of interest. Her fiance opened up the agency she joined.
That makes sense. Okay. That's understandable then. But yeah,
Fiance is one of the OG people who is responsible for Twitch becoming a successful business platform, because he one day received a $10,000 donation on stream.
Wow. But I like these both. It's nice that the former Hololive members, because let's be honest, we're not going to play fucking kayfabe. We all know Kason and Nazuna are both former Hololive members, and...
And speaking of which, congrats to Kason for winning the Like a Dragon contest and becoming a party member in Like a Dragon 8.
Yeah, good honor.
Party member?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, let's fucking go. I didn't think it was that big. Shit. Yeah, that was girl, grand. Getting it.
So this means that she is probably going to be involved in the business minigame, which, considering her in general, is probably going to be VTuber management.
Oh, let's go.
And then she's going to vanish into the business dimension in a cutscene.
That's hilarious.
That series was ruined for me, but good for her.
Ray says, where's my Delta Euro Ninja? He doesn't like Nazuna, and Jay says, Mikineko Nendo Wen.
Mikineko.
Oh, right. I think Mikineko is dead now that Nazuna's a thing.
So,
that's, actually.
I hope you guys like Nendoroid Minions, anyways.
That was also in my notes, was Nendoroid Minions.
Wait, really?
Yeah, I think I just wrote Minions, question mark?
Yeah, I mean, these are actually probably going to be the best figure representations of these characters if you want them. Where
were these Nendoroids when the Hetalia revival came, huh?
There were Nendoroid Hetalia characters.
There's currently a Hetalia Nendoroid right now.
I'm sorry, I'm just making a reference to the fact that there is an in-universe explanation for why the Minions weren't in World War II.
Right. I forgot about the fact that they'd probably be working for Hitler otherwise.
Yeah.
So anyways, Master Chief, you mind telling me what you're doing as a poseable figure? In his SD chibi form.
Were you gonna make that joke?
Yes. Dave is literally like one of the things I was thinking of. I was like,
no, but finishing this
one. Yeah, but this is one of the more articulated Nendos. I am tempted by this to add it to my Master Chief display, but I'm not 100% on it because my Master Chief display is pretty good already.
The funny thing is, you can. If I got this Nendo, I could do a lot of shitpost things with it if I was good at photography. Because I have a Grand Blue Lyrian Nendoroid that if I swapped the heads, this would look really funny.
But yeah, it looks good. It's one of the articulated ones where it's got knees and elbows.
Knees
and toes. Okay, so I do say I wish the visor was either chromed or clear plastic over a silver paint job. As it is, it's kind of flat to me.
Yeah.
So.
Which is why I think it's great as a head swap piece, because it makes it look like the character just got one of those Halo 3 pre-order bonus helmets.
So let's bring up the Bocchi Nendos. We've got Dorito. We got Where's My Money, Bitch? And we got Kita. We got prototypes for all three of the other ones. Unfortunately, I do not expect Nijika to come with her drums, so she's gonna be stuck holding her fucking drumsticks like the meme photo.
I'm sure there's Nendro drums.
There are. I think the Chaos Nendros came with them.
I actually think they also announced a new print or a new line of props that included drums at the last Wonderhobby.
I'll have to check. But also, so more importantly. Go on.
What I see from your drum options are you have the Kaon Nendroid, which is like a billion years old.
Mm-hmm.
And you could actually get Saya from Bang Dream and then like repaint the front of her drums.
Right. The Bang Dream is the thing that exists.
So
yeah, but her drums say Bang Dream right on the front, so you have to do work.
So anyways, more importantly, Kukuri Nendroid. Let's go.
Bocchi character I care about.
Also, Seika too. I like Seika, but Kukuri, man, that's the dream.
There are only three Nendos that, in particular, I want to talk about. Oh, well, technically four.
So hold that thought. Ray brings up that he's not weathered, but he has the scuff on the chest. That is literally a design element that is carried on to every single Master Chief figure from Halo Infinite, is that specific area of his chest is scarred. I don't know why. I think it's fine, but it's very much specifically that part of his chest has been scarred in every single fucking figure of him that's come out.
It looks cool.
And where is PA-san? Where is PA-san? I'm surprised she didn't get announced with these other two. But
I'm surprised that she took off, considering from what I understand, she only showed up for like 3 minutes in the anime.
She's not like super prominent in the animes, but she's there.
And in the manga, from what I understand.
Yeah. So you wanted to bring up three Nendoroids in particular. So what were they? I could bring them.
Four. One is a very quick. It's the last one that has. It's the Twink Shoto, an indie VTuber, the one holding a knife. And I'm just really happy that
this guy.
Yeah, I'm just really surprised that they're giving a lot of indie VTubers, or effectively indie VTubers, Nendos, and I'm really happy.
No, it's so good.
Delta Aya VTuber Nendoroid Wen.
Where's my fucking Nendoroid Wen? I'm an indie VTuber.
You gotta customize it. You're a figure customizer. That's the
whole thing. I am now getting into figure customization, so I could technically do that if I really wanted to.
I gotta say, though, I actually did have a note about the Shoto Nendoroid.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
It's that I clicked on it and I went,
wait, just Shoto? And then I had to double check because for whatever reason, I thought Shoto was with Niji Sanji.
He collabs a lot with Vox and a bunch of the Apex players, but he is completely indie. I think he might be affiliated with an esports team, actually.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah, so...
But him being popular as a VTuber and a singer is always going to be really funny to me. Because he kind of just appeared out of nowhere, unless you apparently keep your head to the Apex scene.
But yeah, there was some other vendors I announced. Blue Archive, the girl from Oni, Onima, Leon.
What was that, Kata?
The Blue Archive Arono Nendoroid was one of the ones I actually had on my notes.
Okay, go on. You want to talk about that more?
I'm really astonished it's taken 2 years of Blue Archive being active for them to get an Nendoroid for its mascot character.
It's two fucking years old?
It's turning 2 years in like a few months.
For JP, at least.
Yes, for JP, but JP is like the main server.
Yeah.
We're back. I think we're back.
We're so back. My order is completely different from both of yours. Okay.
So anyways, he wanted to talk, Kid is going to talk about the fucking Yu-Gi-Oh! Nendoroid. Sorry about the disconnection, the internet be a fuck.
The very short thing about the Blue Archive was I'm shocked it took this long. It better have a hot dog for Arona. And then it's Yusei and Judai from Yu-Gi-Oh! 5Ds and GX. Holy shit! I am so happy they are giving Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro tags that aren't Yu-Gi merchandise.
It's nice, because Judai is also getting a Rebel tech that was revealed a few months ago.
Yeah, and Judai is my favorite protagonist.
I agree.
Yeah, everyone memes on him for being a goofball, but the entire thing is he's slowly dealing with like this pressure and depression that is building up from how he has to be the hero to save everyone. And by the end of the series, he doesn't like the thing he plays anymore. He's playing duels efficiently so he can just get them done, and it's really depressing to watch.
That's pretty good character development. So
Yusei, they need to give him a bike is one thing, and the other really cool thing about Yusei as a character is this is a guy who basically fought a Count of Monte Cristo story to punch his best friend in the face with a card.
Amazing.
Let's go. If he doesn't come with a bike, I'll fucking mail you my Celti bike that I'm not using.
Hell yeah.
So anyways, we're going to move on to pop-up parade because I think we have a few things we might want to discuss here. You wanted to talk about the BlackRock Shooter one to start off with. What is this design from and why does it slap still? I mean, all BlackRock Shooter designs slap, but like this one's pretty good.
This one's from the...
BlackRock Shooter Fragment?
Yeah.
Is that like a mobile game? Okay, mobile game.
BlackRock Shooter got a fucking mobile game?
I think it's a fucking mobile game these days.
That's fair. I didn't actually want to talk about this. I just popped it open, like, randomly, and Kayla was standing over me and was like, oh, she's cute. And I was like, yeah, she's iconic.
Yeah, I'm messing with the BlackRock Shooter Figma from Dawnstar right now.
Rip her eye like fire.
I'm just looking at this real quick, but... I'm looking at the Jean and Jean Alter pop-up parades. What the fuck happened to Jean Alter's tits? They're supposed to be identical to Jean's.
Wow, yeah, okay. she got fucking breast reduction surgery.
Oof, nerfed.
Yeah, holy shit, she is nerfed compared to regular Jean.
What did they alter? Her tits.
Also, wow, they're giving Bess, the only good character in Seven Deadly Sins, a figure.
Which one?
Escanor, the guy with the big axe.
You bring up this, and this one, those proportions are horrible, but that's the point. And two, it brings up memories of the posable figure of him, which I'll bring up in a second. What's his name?
Escanor.
I like the figure that you could get like at regular retail, because I'm pretty sure I saw it at like a Target. It was very good, if memory serves.
I'm going to bring it up because it is hilarious looking.
I love this character. He's the only good thing about this series, in my opinion. His whole power level gimmick is that he gets stronger the closer it is to High Noon, then he slowly gets weaker. But as the series gets on, you realize that the courage that he gets from the sun is actually just part of who he is. His symbol is the lion because of pride, but no, he's actually just...
I hope you like a 20-pack.
Yeah, no, that's actually how Escanor looks.
This looks horrible as an actual articulated figure, though.
Yeah.
Oh, oh no! Oh no! Oh no!
Like, Esfidor does not look... He looks like a One Piece character.
Oh, no. This... McFarlane, I like you guys. This don't look good. But it's also his character designs.
For a One Piece man, he has a neck. Most One Piece men that I see just do not have those.
Or it's just a neck that puts Selden Totsky to shame.
So, I wanted to bring up one, Papa Parade Priestess, one of the best girls in Goblin Slayer. I'm not sure why she's a Papa Parade L size. I don't think they have an L size Goblin Slayer Papa Parade.
Well, that's a lie because we all know she's an S size.
I mean, yes, but where's my fucking Figma Priestess to go with my fucking Goblin Slayer Figma? God fucking damn it.
Wait, I just noticed there's two Helsing.
We'll bring that up in a sec, I guess. But fucking cute as fuck, I'm tempted to buy this, because
why not?
You know, proper prints are relatively inexpensive. Speaking of which, before I move on to fucking Helsing, yo, fucking psychopath figures, 10th anniversary, that aren't gonna fucking break my wallet.
I have a note about this, and it's psychopath is 10 years old.
Yeah, and we're still talking about it 10 years from now. It's an anime people are going to talk about 10 years from now.
It's hard to talk about this series. Kazafi!
But
my everything.
Yeah. But I am very excited for these because I missed out on the Akane Nendoroid, and I do want a representation of one of my favorite anime female anime characters on my shelf.
I do think it's funny that we completely skipped the Shogo Nendo.
There was a Shogo Nendo?
There's a Shogo Nendo.
Wait, did I miss that completely?
Yeah, yeah. If you go back one, it's the next one back.
Oh wait, hold on. Are you going through I just realized. Are you going through the the bar in the bottom instead of like going to the index?
No, we're going to the index. I'm just bringing up what
I'm going to the index. However, I think the difference
There's the Android Shogo. I completely mixed this.
I think the difference is I actually have the site in English right now because my browser didn't want to translate.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, I think it's in different order.
Which, let me see if memory serves correctly. I think I might now be aligned with y'all.
So, you brought up the Helsing OVA pop-up rates, and I think it's great that these older, that both pop-up rate and Nendoroid are doing older iconic anime series.
Yeah.
For like stuff like this. Because like you don't get much merch for them anymore. And back in the day you didn't even get that much merch for them either.
I think with things like Helsing, it's kind of one of those evergreen things where you can just put it out whenever and everyone will just be like, oh cool, have more Helsing stuff.
I think something fun about these figures in particular is that upon looking at them going, oh hey, it's Helsing. I noticed for the first time, I knew that the priest dude's like whole sword thing was that he was holding it in a cross, and I just now noticed that Alucard's is an upside down cross, and also looks better.
Oh, that's amazing. I didn't even notice that. I've never watched Helsing, so.
Father Anderson is a great character, and also voiced by Wakamoto in the Japanese version.
Mm.
Oh, that's dope.
So someone brought up the Megumin. This Megumin is pretty cute.
It's very good. I was like, should I bring it up? And I was like, I'll see if someone else does.
It's very nice. Thank you. Thank you for Shrobe in chat to bring it up. I do like this outfit. It doesn't really fit what I would think of for Konosuba outfits, because I think of it as being very fantasy medievally, and this feels like a very modern costume.
Konosuba has a ton of alt outfits in terms of like figures and artwork.
And also there is like an advanced technology lost civilization, and one of the things was bunny girl stuff.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Aqua's whole thing, after she was sent to go to the world, the quality of heroes that were getting isekai'd went way down, because it turns out Aqua is really good at her job.
That's funny.
And a lot of the people who were isekai'd would bring things like porn magazines back.
Hmm.
But yeah, no, this is something that you'd see in like a promotional image, and I think this may have happened in as a joke in her manga, God Gives Explosions Unto the World or something like that.
Oh, I'm so excited for her anime too.
It's airing.
Yeah, it's airing right now.
Wait, it's airing? Fuck. Yeah.
It's like 7 episodes in, my dude.
I'm so out of the loop.
It's pretty good. But yeah, no, Megumin has always been this character that's kind of like try hard. I'm trying to be sexy and always failing at it, which actually ends up making it.
I was about to say that makes it more attractive. Uh-huh. Anyways, hey, it's everyone's favorite. It's everyone's favorite V artist, Ina. Wait, what's that name? Ichirasu? What?
Ichina. Oh, Ninomai Inanisu. So I'm guessing it just fucked up the transliteration of the katakana.
Yes, I'm assuming so, but I was like, what? But yeah, this looks cute. I'm gonna guess this is what they're gonna do for the Figma 2 instead of including all the tentacles. So it's just gonna be like this for her Figma.
This is supposed from the art when Hollow Myth was originally announced.
Oh, that's adorable.
Oh, man.
She drew, and everyone figured out who she is.
Yeah, because she's a famous actual artist who's worked on Yacha games. But since it's not super public knowledge, we're going to keep it at that. Well, I don't know how public.
Personally, I'm of the opinion that she's probably the most well-known person outside of All Alive.
If you want to know, you can Google it, guys.
And see everyone immediately guess before they announced who she was.
Oh, I did want to bring up, I don't know if I'll find the image for like the group image, but this is like the giantest lady, and they're making a pop-up parade XL version of her. Man. So if you want your big ladies, go get that, I guess.
L size.
XL size.
XL size.
And it's scaled to, has the same scaling as a Gundam model kit.
Yeah. So we're going to move on to scale figures if there's anything else, unless there's anything else you want to bring up with pop-up parades.
This is anemic.
Yeah, like I said, this is a very anemic year.
Yeah, no.
And we're not trying to talk about everything, because last time we did that, we were here for like 5 fucking hours.
Talk about everything because of how little there is.
It's true.
We could, but like, I don't really have much to say about some of these stuff, so I'm just like,
yeah.
I'm being a bad podcast host and just kind of like, eh.
Talk about things of notes.
Yeah. So
as far as scales go,
scales, it's also pretty anemic too.
But the scales they showed off actually generally, for the most part, look pretty good. Like, holy shit, that Nezuko scale.
Nezuko. Oh yes, this one. It is actually like just making a piece of artwork you'd hang up on the wall, but it's also 3D. This is fantastic. Also, fucking thank God I don't really care about Demon Slayer, because
this will probably be, frankly, I would not be surprised if it broke 1,000.
Yeah, 1,000.
I do kind of hope that it has a notch in the back so you can hang it.
It has to. Like, why? It's got a fucking painting frame.
Well, to be fair, this would be extremely heavy to actually hang.
That too. But I mean, you find a wall stud, those things can hold up TVs.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm more worried about the figure itself than the thing that's holding it.
Oh, like if it falls, it'll fucking break itself into a billion pieces?
Yeah.
Or at least 2 or 3.
Might not be well distributed to hang.
Although it does look like, oh no, it's not hanging. It is sitting on like a surface.
Yeah, it's like angled on a surface right now. Probably like with a little stand thing behind it.
Yeah, there's also the, as Jay mentioned, the seventh scripture seal scale figure.
Which one is that?
The one of Karashi's girlfriend, wife. Or no, was it Karashi?
I was gonna say like, wait, girlfriend? But I was like, I mean, they're basically dating, so. I just kind of assumed it, but I was like, I don't want to make assumptions about people's like relationships with other people.
I meant wife type, girlfriend type thing.
I 100% didn't realize this was the one of the Tsukihime girls.
Yeah, yeah. It's CL, and fucking holy shit, that fucking sword is literally like 90% of that figure.
And people say Monster Hunter weapons are absurd. Actually, this is not as big as...
I was about to say, I've seen bigger Monster Hunter weapons.
I mean, I could definitely see it in Mon Hun, though.
There are three great swords larger than that in Monster Hunter.
So,
bad weapons.
So what's going to cost more, the figure or the shipping?
Shipping.
Shipping. That box is going to be hell.
Like, I feel that they ship based off of size more often than not, rather than weight for some things. And this is one of those things where the box is just so massive.
Yeah.
Jay brings up that Nasu went wild on the remake. Is the remake fully out yet or not?
They have the near side, which would be Ark and CL's route. Basically.
Okay, so the main two
far
girls,
side,
basically.
Would be the main, yeah, far side would be the maids, and apparently Satsuki is getting her route finally.
They're didn't they say they're like not doing a translation into English, and so it's up to fans again?
Basically.
Is that a thing? Yeah, I saw
I think
something
they
about
said
that.
They're going to, but like it's going to be console only.
So it's going to be heavily like toned down.
I mean, it's console only right now.
Oh.
On Switch.
Switch and PS and PlayStation. Like, Nasu does not think you should play this game on PC.
That makes no sense though, because visual novels is like. They
PC
was like,
bread and butter.
Yeah, PC bread and butter.
Though the Switch is a visual novel machine.
When it comes to how Fate and his IPs should be handled. Remember, this is the man who thinks that, no, Altria is correct.
Oh, right. Yeah. Yeah, Nasu's just fucking insane.
This is the guy who, the only way you're ever going to talk him out of an idea is if his roommate, Takeuchi, says, hey, what if we do this instead?
So, anyways, bringing up, going back to the Miku's 16th birthday, they got a scale version of this design, and it looks way better. Holy shit!
It looks so good.
And that the detail on like the, I was gonna say it looks like machine gun style, like a guitar, and that looks like bullets, but it's keys from a piano.
Yeah, that's like really good.
But it looks sick.
I'm hope very they do excited to see what the base is like.
Yeah.
The base right now is just plain, so I do hope there's something to help stand this up beyond just the base, because it's one leg.
I'm sure there will be. I'm sure there will be.
Going back to Miku, this racing Miku is extremely good.
I'm not the biggest fan of it. I prefer the normal 2020
racing. Oh, it's Azur Lane Miku.
Yeah, it is Azur Lane Miku.
Well, actually, that's more Kantai Collection Shimakaze, to be honest.
Yeah, I get little bits of it from the top half, but the bottom half is just like doesn't really.
Okay, but the midriff though, the midriff is real good. That's like what I mean.
It is good.
What else for scale statues? You got the big old 1/4 scale version of the fucking whatever her name is.
Oh, Marine.
Yeah.
Marine.
Bocchi's getting a full like scale figure along with the other four girls. Yeah.
Let's go. Getting the band back together.
Nikkei scale figures, which
I am kind of surprised they're going with that girl.
I'm surprised they're going for these two girls as like their main like the like some of the first figure releases. Like
I've never seen either of these.
I figured
learning that Modernia is part of the main story, that makes some sense, but you'd kind of expect like Annis or Alice even.
Yeah, or Alice Rocky, is the pink Alice is the pink bodysuit girl, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I would have thought she would have been like one of the ones to go get a figure first.
Alice, the girl who wears a cooling suit, but why if she is always hot? But it's because I mean, not always
This is where I get to voice my one opinion about Nikkei that I've never gotten to voice that I've always wanted to. There's a girl you meet in the main story very early on. The one with the skirt. Her trope is the her skirt's pulled up by her school bag. I forget what her name is.
It's not Shuen, is it?
I don't think it is.
Because she's not a Nikkei.
No, there is a Nikkei girl who like you meet like immediately. Like she's like your third. Oh no, Suen is the CEO. The CEO is an asshole.
Oh, I know who you're talking about. The girl who announces that she is a spy girl.
Yes, that girl. I just want to take this moment to say, I fucking hate the trope of, oh, my school bag is holding up my skirt. Like, it looks like shit. It's a bad
Neon. That's her name.
So Jay brings up, it's like ancient Greek statues. It's a sign of good workmanship if your statue can stand up on its feet without any supports. You know, it really is. Even thousands of years later, that's a sign of craftsmanship.
Welcome back, Ray.
Hey, welcome back, Ray. We're just talking about the scale figures because, boy, this is—it's an anemic year, or
it's a
spring.
Bare bones year. Plastic models is completely empty.
There's nothing for plastic models. Scale figures is anemic. Figma's being anemic for fucking the last few. It feels like.
I'm surprised they're doing a Blue Archive scale of Aris, like, in the maid outfit this quickly, considering the maid event just finished, like, 2 weeks ago in Japan.
Hey, capitalize on the thing when it's hot, even though this will come out, like, a year or two later.
6 months, actually, for, you mean the figure.
Yeah.
because the event will drop in, like, I want to say October.
Listen, the minute they announce, listen, Ray, the minute they announce the fucking Toki Bunny Girl, I'm getting that. I haven't played Blue Archive in forever. Anyway, sorry.
Well, I'm astonished Toki got an alt that fast, because she had been a playable character for a fucking month, and then the alts came out.
Hey, capitalize on when you know a character's super popular.
Oops, it's the wild thing. She has more art. She has more art right now than I think either of the other maid bunny girls.
I think you're right, because I looked through my Twitter bookmarks and like 70% of it is just Toki art.
And 90%, much like the other maids, 90% of her art is her in the bunny suits.
Jay says Kisaki figure when. I'm surprised she hasn't got one announced.
Has three lines in the main story, apparently.
I say, isn't she not playable? She's just like an NPC, right?
An NPC, I think she had 8 lines in the main story or in an event, 4 of which were in a flashback.
Incredible. Or are we going to the Hobby Denki?
Yeah, I'm going to bring up some of the Hobby Denki stuff. We got our 1/4 scale freeing bunny girl, Usada Pekko, which is probably the most appropriate thing they've ever done.
That decor is very cute.
It is very cute. It is 1/4 scale, so it's huge.
And gonna cost a fucking arm and a leg.
You say that they're like only $200, which I'm thinking it's not that bad these days.
It's also a 1/4 scale, which are generally pretty expensive, but they're usually relatively cheap, all things considered.
Yeah, like the price to value ratio is actually pretty bad.
Yeah.
It's the Stinky Orca next.
Yes,
right?
Stinky Orca girl. I'm gonna be real. I saw this face for a second, and my first thought is, wait, when did Asanagi design her? Something about the eyes gave me that vibe.
For me, it's not the eyes, it's the cheeks.
The cheeks?
True and fair.
Asanagi designs or draws the cheeks in a very particular way that can make me immediately recognize them. But also, because I know Asanagi's been designing figures lately, I know that if he drew Chloe, she'd get like 8 cup sizes.
Yeah, it's too restrained to be an Asanagi figure designed. And this is by Max Factory. The previously mentioned Papa Parade, Ina, which looks great. I'm just going to buy her Figma, though.
A bunch we already talked about.
Yeah, and some of the Nendoroids that we got mentioned. So this is just the Vtuber and Hetsu. Oh, wow, yeah, this fucking Miku looks great from other angles. Holy shit.
Yeah, no, it's gorgeous.
Like, that is incredible.
And then you go to the Nendo, and it's like, well, the Nendo looks fine, but...
It doesn't have the grandiose of this, so it's like...
No, like, that design is meant to be like a, whoa. And, like, the Nendoroid is like, it's nice, but it also just doesn't bring that whoa factor.
Yeah.
The Miku scale afterwards that we didn't talk about is very cheap.
It is. Like I think we brought this up last time?
Did we? I don't remember. It's been a long time for me.
I think we brought up this one of these previous ones. That's why I didn't really mention it.
Yeah, no, it was after you left on the last podcast.
I think most of these, aside from the racing Miku, was brought up. Yeah, this is all just Mikus now. So
I say that I did write in my notes, Miku fans eating good.
Yeah, Miku fans eating good.
I do like the girl looking back, Miku Nendo. But yeah. Anyway.
I'm just going through my other things that I brought up. The video game stuff. So this is signed from fucking Fire Emblem. I don't know anything. I don't know anything about this design, but it's fucking hot.
That's the
evil Corrin in Heroes, I believe.
Fun fact, that was the only Figma I've ever sold. Not that design.
Okay, so Ray, I just checked chat. Ray says, shut up. I said, Haki, no, shut up. he also says that any anime figure collector should have some form of Miku merch. I only have like a small keychain of... No, wait. I was about to say...
You've got the Blackrock Shooter, bitch.
I've got the... Well, Blackrock Shooter, I don't count as Miku at these days.
It's Miku. It's fucking Miku.
But I was about to say, I have the Frame Arms crossover Mecha Miku figure from
the model kit. I don't know Miku. I also missed the Miku event in Blue Archives, so I didn't get her there.
Oof.
But finally, sorry. I do want to pick up that Miku, the 100th, what is it, the 100th Figma? The Miku 2.0 that was like a big celebration for Figma.
Oh, that was a really cute Miku.
Oh, yeah.
But this Corrin design is hella hot.
To be honest, it's basically just Corrin, but they made her armor black.
Well, they say that, Corrin? But also leotard.
No, that's just Corrin's outfit.
I was saying, that's just how she looks, dude.
Oh, really? I thought she had like a full plate armor of tights and stuff.
No, or it's weird because she is going barefoot in the game where they figured out how to animate feet.
They even focused on the feet in this one image.
Because it's literally their defining trait for both male and female.
Yeah, that's the Corrin charm point.
Ah, just like the Hibiki charm point.
No,
and that is retailing for 28,000 yen. If you're a Fire Emblem fan, you're gonna eat good, but you're also gonna be fucking eating ramen too. And there's the Alucard fucking Figma again, looking dired. Arcade, whatever the fuck her name is.
I just call her Arcade Turkey Handle.
We got a Danganronpa Papa Parade, which I don't think was mentioned in the main thing.
I did not see it.
Looks nice.
It was, but we kind of just skimmed over it.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just going through the video game section right now, so.
Kata, are you a Danganronpa?
No, not really.
I'll say that no one here does Danganronpa, so.
Yeah, and Colorful Kitchen is not in chat, so she has nothing to contribute.
I think this character... fucking Raging Wolf.
So this guy has been fucking on prototype for at least, like, over a year at this point. It's like, Figma, get off the pot or fucking drop it. Come the fuck on.
Gotta wait for... They're gonna drop color Raging Wolf when Elden Ring DLC drops.
I hate that you're probably right about that.
Yup.
I hate that you're right about this. Also, I don't even know who this character is.
It's like Date Alive.
Wait, this guy... Oh.
The girl.
Oh, I was talking about the Raging Wolf dude.
Raging Wolf.
Yeah, Raging Wolf is not a character. Raging Wolf is just an armor set.
Okay.
And then there's also, we skipped over him, but a pyramid head or red pyramid
was
thing.
Was his color scheme always like that?
No, he does not have gray arms. I don't know where the fuck they got that from.
I mean, I meant more so his pyramid being black and red. I thought
that's
it was all,
that's
like...
always kind of been the thing. It's kind of been like a rusty.
Kind of like. It's like JoJo. The color is inconsistent between scenes.
That's fair.
Ray says Raging Wolf is like some mercenary guy you kill in a one section. Okay. Fucking this Rika that. Statue is a repaint of one that was released earlier last year. It looks nice.
Okay. That art style actually doesn't make it look like Rika. It makes it look like...
That one Idolmaster girl?
Wait, that is an Idolmaster girl, I think.
Yeah, but no, this is the Rika from Higurashi. This scale statue was released a while back, but this is a repaint of it. Instead of a blue swimsuit, it's white.
Okay.
But I did want to bring up the Buzzma Tubi, which looks pretty great, in my opinion.
Oh, is that posable?
Yeah, it's posable.
Oh, hot damn.
It's got, it does have a fabric skirt, which I think works better, I'll be honest.
Okay, probably.
So this is something that is entirely just a result of it having articulation, but one of those shots You can see up the leotard, and it looks really weird.
Well, I mean, it's you can see, like, the joint lines on that, but like.
Yeah, but it ends up making it look really horny.
I mean, I don't think most 2B people would complain about that, so.
She got that deep P asterisk SSY.
You can say that word on stream.
I can, but it's funnier if I say it in a horrible way.
But I think this is on pre-order right now at, like, Right Stuff and other people who sell BuzzMods figures. So I'm tempted to pick the... Also, she's very leggy, but that's just 2B's design.
Yeah.
How much is it?
The real star of this duo, the fucking pod.
The pod. No, she is.
Oh god.
She's about 1,200 yen, which is, I'll be honest, not that much more expensive than a Figma.
Yeah.
I mean, on Aniplex's site, she's $116, which is why I screamed, "Oh god."
Yeah. The yen discount does not apply to the import stuff for that skate. But
let me see if I can find her on a site that fucking.
You are not. They're very selective in where they sell BuzzMods. Right Stuff, I think, has it for about the same price.
I can see that.
But I think this.
Comes the next page.
I still need to fucking get my Nier Automata signed by a couple more voice actors.
Hold on. This is the wrong thing, but hey, the Chris Virgin Sweater figure is out, by the way, if anyone cares about
again?
That. No, it just came out.
Like 3 times.
And why they made it, but don't get why they made it, if you catch me.
So, we were talking about Figma earlier, and Bocchi, obviously, was one of the things. One thing I did want to bring up is, so Sega is getting into the posable figure market with...
Oh, yeah.
With the quintessential
quintuplets.
Yes, that show. And, like, the figure looks pretty good, I think. It's not, like, the most articulated. It's about Figma articulated. It has very limited accessories, but I don't know what she could come with. But the price is the thing. She is retailing for $38 for a figure that looks pretty good. And it makes me question how much better... is Figma for like $70-$90 more. Like
Ray, it looks like a prize figure with articulation, but it's also priced like a prize figure with articulation.
Yeah. So it's like, you have to wonder, like, should we be putting up with Figma's absurd pricing at this point?
No.
Cause like, it's just, it's so much. Like, you look at Figma prices and you're like, why?
You might be like, you know, this quintessential quintuplet Ichika Nakano doesn't look great, but then I look at the arcade that they fucking just
dropped,
like, put out that picture of, and I'm like, you know what? If that arcade was $38.99, maybe I'd pay for it if I was a Tsukihime fan.
Well, I mean, let's be honest. This figure has better looking joints than that fucking arcade.
Yeah.
But I mean, the elbows, yeah, they're obvious, but like, that's just the character design you have to work around. But she doesn't have an ugly fucking torso joint. She has fucking good looking knees. Her thigh swivel's probably hidden with those shorts. Looks, joint wise, it looks a whole lot better than the fucking Arcred for fucking $40 less.
No, it looks fine for the price tag.
Yeah. But we need more competition. Yeah.
Yeah, what I'll say is now is, if Mobip came out today, it would be like way different than it was when that actually came out.
So
if people remember Mobip.
I was about to say, how many people here remember Mobip?
How many people here bought Mobip, or was it just me?
What the fuck is Mobip?
All right, time for a history lesson.
So Mobip was a figure line. That was basically a Figma knockoff.
Competitor. Let's give some respect to them.
A Figma competitor. I don't know if they ever released anything else, but their main claim to fame was that they released figures of Little Busters.
So there were about.
I will drop a pic in the chat.
I brought up the thing. They released at least 7. I think they might have released a little bit more. But they did. They're basically a Figma competitor line back in the late 2000s, early 2000s. they did stuff for Little Busters. And, you know, this looks okay for 2008, or whatever it came out. 2009.
Okay.
So, like, very early Figma competitor. And you can tell they're very much early competitors, because, like, just the joint design and all that. And it unfortunately died very early on before it could really get its fucking legs, I think, which is a shame. Because it let Figma basically fucking run over, like, the entire fucking anime figure industry for, like, a good couple years before Figure Arts got its shit together with anime figures, and then... And then, you know, I mean, obviously it's not the prettiest looking figure, because, you know, it's obviously a company's, like, first, like, run doing this type of stuff, but, like, it's adequate, and, like, back in the day, it was only, let me bring up back to the main page, it was only, like, $16! Or 20-something dollars, probably.
I remember Figma used to be super cheap.
They were relatively cheap. Let me just bring up Figma Nanoha from, like, back in the day and compare the price.
Oh, let me pop open my figure collection's Mobip. Hey, can you open?
Pages. So, yeah, the Nanoha Figma's just going for, like, something around the same time frame.
I remember when I met you, you were talking about Figma prices, and I was like, I didn't comment back then, but it was like, what the fuck? When did Figma get expensive?
Yeah. Figma back in the day were about, like, 25,000 yen.
They're the price of... They're less than a Nendoroid today.
Yeah. They were really cheap, and they came with a lot. But yeah, Figma, Mobip did, like, two Little Busters. They did the K-On! Girls before Figma got around to them. And then they did a Strike Witch, and then the line died.
Rip.
A little bit of a shame now. The panty shot promo pick.
Strike Witches would kill the line. That tends to be the case with a lot of people who try to do something based off of Strike Witches, I feel.
Yeah.
But yeah, I owned Mobip. What the fuck is this girl's name?
Rin, I think her name was.
I think you're right, but I'm letting it load before I confirm, just to cover my ass. Yeah, Natsume Rin. I owned that figure, and it was fine, actually. I liked it quite a bit, but I was a ham-handed child.
And you broke it.
I did, because I'm an idiot. But that was on me, not on Mobip.
And I feel bad that this line died, but Aoshima is doing fine. They're doing their VFF girls now as, like, their poseable girl figures for Macross. And you'll go
Freya when?
Yeah, you're going to get your Freya eventually. They have it planned.
And I'm going to lose my mind and my wallet.
Yeah. But was there anything else I had brought up from Wonderhobby? Because there was a bunch of, like, there's the freeing statues for Marin and the Uzaki.
On the next page, but it's aside from the Wonder Knight, Hollow Knight duo and the girl from Needy Streamer Overdose.
Oh my god, Kawaii Angel.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, here's the picture of the fucking extra large pop-up parade. She is big.
Okay, actually, I'm just a quick aside about K Angel in Needy Girl. I'm kind of surprised that the song for Needy Internet
Streamer. Oh, Internet Girl, Yamero?
Yeah, I'm surprised that suddenly took off and turned into the new dance animation meme that everyone's posting on TikTok and YouTube Shorts.
I wouldn't know. I don't really pay attention to YouTube Shorts or TikTok.
I think it's a two-part thing. I think it's number one, most people who make those don't like understand Japanese, so they don't really know the content of the song, so they don't really care. I guess it's a three-part thing. Number two, the song is fucking incredible. It's so good. I love that song, just from a listening perspective. And number three, the dance animation that people are doing is relatively
easy,
simple. Yeah.
No, yeah, I get it, but it's, like, really funny because,
it
like,
is funny.
So
don't love that they're dancing to, like, a song about doing a lot of ecstasy and drugs.
Yeah, illicit, like, drugs and fucking mental health.
Dance moves themselves are a reference to uppers and downers.
Oh, that's so fucking
funny. So, Ray, you bring up the Rebel Tech doing the anime game market thing. I know they're doing, and we didn't bring this up because it was, like, in between events, so we didn't really cover it, which honestly might be a case for us to do a monthly podcast instead of a quarterly podcast, but that's besides the point. We'll talk about that later.
Mode as well.
But Rebel Tech's, you know, doing figures for index and rail get thing. I didn't know they were doing Honkai style rail things until you mentioned it. Was that just like very recently?
I'll post pictures in the chat.
Because I did not know this.
I believe the doll joint girl too.
Oh,
Who has laser targeted half of my timeline?
Oh, they're targeting me specifically. So
I might bite because I love the Honkai Star Rail like designs. But
this looks good. Where the fuck did this come from? I didn't hear anything about this until today. Huh. But yeah, we need more competition to Figma because they were the giants and now they're fucking resting on their laurels. They're also fucking dying from the inside. And I don't know what the fuck Max Factory's doing.
It was good in Goodsmile Shanghai is what Ray says.
Oh, Goodsmile Shanghai event.
That's what they say at least, they think.
Huh. But yeah, the market is open for competitors and there's multiple competitors starting to step up the game. Rebel Tech starting to do anime girls again. Obviously BuzzMod is continuing to do its thing. Figure Arts is killing it with the fucking anime figures they've been doing recently. I mean, look at the Chainsaw Man figures.
Yeah, to be fair with the Chainsaw Man stuff, it's hard to do worse than the competitor.
It's hard to do worse than Lorik.
Or even do
Lorik.
God, what the fuck happened with the Chainsaw Man Figmas?
They're so bad.
Rushed
is the main thing.
Yeah.
Aki looks at least decent, but still.
He looks fine, but I think he's going to be the one out of the main trio to do well. Aki, I don't know. It'd be a tie between Aki and Denji for who I'd put my money on for doing worse in terms of just character popularity.
Where's my Himeno Figma? That's not going to happen. That's never going to happen.
Just get like a 112 scale dress shirt and put it on the ground. I will admit though, I am a little surprised that there wasn't even a placard for a Figma Makima.
That is okay. So we're bringing up Thor. We're still on Figma. Thorfinn actually looks a little bit better here.
Yeah. So it may have just been a shot thing.
Yeah. He actually does look a little bit better here.
I still think his soft goods looked better in the prototype, but he doesn't look bad. He doesn't look bad, is what I'll say.
Oh yeah,
the remake of the old figure, I believe.
No, this is not the Figma 2.0. This is like a separate, like 12-inch figure.
Okay.
Oh. Also Shoko from what's her name? I don't know if I can...
Oh, Komi.
Okay, so let's see if there's anything else. I feel like I'm trying to like run this on for a little bit longer, but like. I mean, I'm having fun talking, but still.
I mean, it's been like, I think, almost an hour. It's been an hour and a half at least.
Yeah. Social Gate Work. Ooh, some nice figures of a Blue Archive girl.
Oh, you want to link that?
It's in the social game.
Social game stuff? Okay. Social games. Special.
Immediately open up to tentacles.
Because if not, I was going to bring up the Tamashii event, because there was a few things there that I thought might be interesting.
More shots of the...
Yeah, I saw the statue earlier, like, wow, that's a fucking... Yeah.
That
man, they really fucking vacuum suck Jalter's tits away. Holy shit.
Why you keep mentioning that?
It's so dramatic. It's so noticeable. Like, yeah, it's unignorable.
Yeah, Jalta, what happened to your tits? And then she murders you for saying that.
I mean, I feel like she'd murder me for looking at her at all.
I mean, that's true.
Why don't you just bring up the fact that she writes mediocre doujinshi, which is actually... a lot of Danmachi stuff in light novel section.
I'm shocked Danmachi is still alive.
I saw like a I did want to bring up like that one Danmachi pop up parade. Light novel section.
Sorry, hold on a second. Kato, what'd you say about Danmachi?
It's a pretty popular light novel.
Command skills. Ray brings up command skills can pacify Jalter. Well, I mean, that's the plot of many of doujins.
I'm surprised Danmachi is as popular as it is because I remember watching the first season of the show. And then I forgot everything about it, even though I know I finished it.
I liked the first season. The second season was mediocre. Then it had a really good second arc that fucking shat the bed so hard in the final two episodes with one line. The final two episodes, or the second to last episode, revealed that the crux of why they wanted to save the person they wanted to and why she had such hangups, all of it was a lie. None of it existed.
That's a big oof.
Way to disqualify your own narrative.
Yeah, and you know what that thing was? That she was a prostitute, and as such, she was impure and wasn't worth saving. So, learning that all of that never actually happened, you can feel the editor's hand in that.
Yeah, it's no good. But you know what's good? This elf girl having her ass just hanging out. Jeez, that's on the side in half.
She is voiced by Sari Hayami, and she is a really cool character.
Oh, neato. But I like that design. It's a little bit weird. She's just wearing fucking bloomers, but whatever.
Yeah, I'd actually compare her to, like, a prototype of a high elf archer, almost.
A little bit. I can see it, yeah. Novel stuff. Is that everyone's favorite dual-wielding black swordsman?
Kirito?
Yeah, it's a Kirito!
So,
actually,
Kirito? Sorry, continue?
No, I really like Kirito.
Fair. My one thing is, I saw this figure, and I saw that, like, it was, like, a specific design of him, and I'm like, the only design of his that I can distinguish and be like, oh, yeah, it's that one, is when he's a fucking girl.
It's true. That's his best design.
I'm like, I get it. You want to make all your game avatars look exactly the same, but it's really distracting when you go to completely different games, and yet you're able to make almost exactly the same person.
I can recognize the difference between him and the first avatar he had when he went to Alfheim, which was the fairy with the spiky hair.
Oh, and, true. When he does change his hairstyle, I guess, yeah. I can see that.
Distinguish it from Alization, but that's not because of the appearance. That's, or his, like, hair or anything. It's because his coat is blue, or is a dark blue instead of black.
So, Tech, I heard you like your murder wifers.
I do like my blue-haired, unhinged girls, especially Ami from Toradora and Ryoko from Haruhi. So I saw this, and I was like, why are you shooting me specifically?
Which one is this? Is this the Haruhi one, or the...
No, this is the one from Toradora.
Okay, I was about to say, they look basically the same to me.
They do. I guess what? Sometimes I have a type, and that's fine, and that's okay, and I'm allowed.
Gray than it is to that shade of blue, to be honest. Oh, look, Raphaelia.
So this is a weird one to me. I think it looks cute, obviously, but it's like, it's supposed to be a bunny suit, but like, she's just got bunny ears and then lingerie on.
Well, you see, it's because they need to remind you that she's a slave.
Also, I hope you like Robot Loli.
The coolest thing that we never really got to see in the
I only know this character as having a figure that's bent over in such a way that people often use it as a phone holder.
No. This is a really cool character in No Game No Life, but she is
No Game No Life. Shit. Showing my whole ass. Damn.
Okay, so this is just the
show that made a lot of people really upset.
So I will bring up this figure from Kumo whatever. I like how the texturing on the fucking thing looks actually kind of like flocked.
Yeah, it looks really good.
It's probably not actually fabric or flocked or anything like that, but it's really nice subtle detailing on that. I don't know anything about the show. I think it looks ridiculous, but let's be honest.
It's a silly isekai.
The thing is
that she's wearing a bear pajama suit.
Yeah. But I'm just like, let's be honest, every fucking piece of media, when you get down to it, is ridiculous in some way or another.
Yeah.
So, I'm gonna stop by at the Tamashii WT flash report, because there was a Tamashii event.
Oh, can you link it?
I will link it just in a sec. I don't think there'll be much to talk about here, but I do think it's important to at least cover it, since it was the other big event going on the weekend. And most of us are familiar with, you know, Tamashii Nations. So we got Metal Build Exia? I don't know what fucking mobile suit this is from fucking Gundam 00. I just know it's a Gundam 00 thing because of the chest and has a circle in it.
That's the Astraea Mark II.
Ah, Astraea Mark II. Okay, so I don't recognize any of these suits, really. Proto EX unit. And those are Bandai's metal build line, which I have bought a metal build of the Kamaris Vidar, and it's very good.
Serbine. That looks cool.
The Serbine from Dunbine, which very it looks good.
What's that from?
The Arbalest from Metal Panic. Oh, Full Metal Panic. Both versions, both this one and the Wing Packed one.
Which... I haven't actually seen much of Full Metal Panic, so.
And this is what figure of this is of the new Gundam? Oh. Oh my god, look at that price tag. Holy shit. Also, it's been out for like 2 years. What the fuck? Why is this being shown off?
2,000 yen.
That's more than a car payment.
That thing better suck your dick.
I don't know if I want the new Gundam to suck my dick.
Well, considering what's in the aerial, best not to have it do that.
There was also, like, there was showing off some of the robot Dharma sheets for Gundam Seed, and me and Ray popped off at fucking the best Gundam from Gundam Seed, getting a fucking...
Buster?
Yeah, fucking Buster robot Dharma sheet. Probably the first good figure of the Buster Gundam since the... I was gonna say the high grade from, you know, the early 2000s, but then I remember the Master Grade came out. But still.
Was, I gotta ask now, was the Blitz Gundam the one piloted by the guy with the piano trauma, or...
Yes.
Am I thinking of someone else?
Okay. Yes. Yes. Nicole was 15. He loved to play the piano.
I got a few more pages in me before I gotta dip to bed.
Yeah, we're gonna end soon. We're just probably gonna...
Page 3 has Zoids, and frankly, these all look really cool. I love Zoids.
Yeah, there's the Blitz Gundam,
I don't
Strike.
Know shit about Zoids.
Yeah, I don't know anything about Zoids.
Same.
I watched Swords when it was on Toonami, and I don't remember anything aside from like that one.
Like one of the most butchered dubs ever.
I just remember that one girl in the sniper thing with the red hair, and that's about it.
Yeah. Nope. No there's tracker. A Kamen Rider Ichigo.
Okay, so this is all the Swords. Yeah, that looks cool. Swords look cool, but I don't really care about them.
There's some Toku stuff.
Yeah, let's get to the Toku stuff, so that's relevant to both. Okay, yeah, so special effects.
It's weird how glossy his face is.
Yeah, that's usually an issue with face printing. But
given that his armor is a matte, I'm very shocked.
So what I hate is that they're selling this separate from the one they released already, and he doesn't come with the coat. So would you either get a poseable fabric coat or a poseable fabric scarf? And I'm just like, you could have done both. The base figure is pretty good, though. I think his shoulder articulation is a bit limited, but... You know, this is a good figure. This is a good variant of it if you want, like, the poseable scarf. Otherwise, I'm gonna pass. We have...
It's all Ultraman.
I'm gonna be real with you. This is probably the most unique-looking Ultraman I've seen in a while, just because of the light blue.
Oh, fair.
Yeah.
You don't see that used for Ultraman. Usually it's just red or, you know, navy blue.
Like that. I know a lot of Ultras actually use blue in some, if they have a form shift gimmick. But I don't know how often form shifts happen in Ultra anymore. I know Tiga had form shifts.
I think form shifts are still a thing. So we're going to bring up the jump stuff because we might as well. We got Lloyd.
I legitimately did not recognize that as being Lloyd.
We got Lloyd from Spy X Family. We got...
Lloyd has the most scattershot quality in terms of figures, because sometimes he looks fine and sometimes he looks like a bootleg of himself.
we got everyone's favorite MILF, Yor
in the fucking iconic sweater.
She might as well just be a statue from the waist down, because look at it. Why does she even have knees? She's not going to be able to use those knees.
Sorry, Kato, what was that?
It's just really funny because I really like Spy Family, but I know a lot of people who think that who don't like Spy Family for the reason that no one in this show knows what sex is, but all the fans think they are constantly fucking.
That's fair.
That's understandable.
The only person who knows what sex probably is Anya, and she should not know what sex is.
She knows what it is because someone horny was within 40 feet of her.
Oh no, Ray said their Spy X Family stuff got canceled. That sucks.
Wait.
Jim says, I got 15 minutes before you get home. How should I poison yourself? With cyanide. No, don't. I'm joking. Do not.
Ming River Baishu? Get Ming River Baishu, because I don't know what the other thing is.
Jim was talking about that in my stream chat the other day. I don't know much about alcohol, so I couldn't give a good recommendation.
Have you ever had black licorice?
Me or Jim?
You, Kata.
No, I don't drink alcohol in general.
No, black licorice, like the candy.
I hate black licorice. So fucking
much. That's what Ming River Baishu, the alcohol, tastes like.
Yeah. That sounds awful. That sounds awful.
It's fine.
I just don't like black licorice.
No, that's fair. But it's also that flavor still.
And my mother, though she loves black licorice, can't help have that alcohol.
Oh, that's
cool. That's unfortunate. So we got Anya. I'm going to move back to this. So we got Anya and a poseable dog.
It's Bond. Actually, Bond. His name is Bond. He has a name.
Yeah, because he's obsessed with spying.
But hey, poseable dog figure arts.
Powerful.
Figure arts mini. We don't really care about figure arts mini really all that much.
I'm glad that figure arts mini exists, if only to fucking push Nendroid's buttons.
Yes, I do have the figure arts mini Himeno from Chainsaw Man on pre-order. So
this boy looks even more jank than the other one.
Yeah, poor Lloyd. You kept mentioning that boy looks like a bootleg of himself. Boy, does he look like a bootleg of himself.
You know, Anya is literally just an Nendroid in anime form.
Yeah.
It's true.
So we got another Goku. I don't know which version of Goku this is.
This is from the cooler anime or movie.
Super Saiyan Son Goku, Legendary Super Saiyan. That's like such a... Is this the thing when he beats up Frieza? I don't know.
No, I think he's fighting cooler. Legendary Super Saiyan Goku was just any time where he's like seriously fucked up.
We have Metal Cooler, which was revealed earlier, but this is like the second or third chromed figure arts figure. The first one was the Garo figure, and then
this is also from the movie, so.
Yeah, and then the second figure arts that was chromed the fuck was another variant of Garo. So this is the third one, and it's very much expensive due to the chrome. Also, it's going to be a figure print magnet. But it looks cool. Metal Cooler is cool.
Yeah, he's cooler than Frieza.
Yes. And then you have they're doing One Piece figure arts again. We have
Yamato, the character who is hard to talk about because they won't acknowledge they are trans in the actual manga.
Yes, it's really awkward.
I did not know about that.
Yeah, Yamato, if memory serves, goes by he him pronouns, and is like, I am a man, but obviously there's awkward tiptoeing around that.
Yeah, because of Jump Editorial, and it's a weird thing where it's like, actually, it's kind of like the Mordred thing in Fate, where it's they just don't want to be called a woman because they see women as not able to be taken seriously, but it's like such awkward, it's so awkwardly handled.
Oda is not one for good social issues.
Yeah.
I mean, considering the people he hangs around with, that's not surprising.
Orochimaru, unironically, turned into a pretty cool LGBT man.
Wait, what?
So if you're... Orochimaru's voice actor is kind of like an iconic LGBT adjacent voice actor. What? So Orochimaru kind of got saddled with being a non-binary, gender-fluid parent.
Oh, that's neato, I guess. Anyways, the figure arts looks cool. I mentioned this to Sari at one point. I'm surprised they're doing Orochimaru before doing a Hinata.
People because Orochimaru a lot.
Yeah, and then you got this chick from Saint Seiya, but nobody in the Western world gives a shit about Saint Seiya.
Her face is very strange.
Nobody in the United States and Canada gives a shit about Saint Seiya. Go South down America. And then you hit Mexico.
Yeah, go to Mexico and you'll find people who care about this, but none of us here are Mexican. We do not have a Mexican correspondent.
I actually do like Saint Seiya. And I am Filipino, so I'm close enough. Saint Seiya is pretty big in the Philippines too, from what I understand.
So Ray brings up Orochimaru did not get an SH figure arts. This is their first one, I think. And that's it for Tamashii Nation. So we're gonna wrap it up, I guess, in a bit. So final thoughts.
I'm gonna dip out right now. Final thoughts. Figma dying real? Figma dying for real? Hell yeah, let's go. healing. Keep figures back. Yeah, that's it. Miku's great. I love you all. Have a lovely night. Goodbye.
Adios. So I'm gonna continue on for a little bit, I guess. Katie, you got your final thoughts?
So it was so anemic, there is nothing to talk about.
Yes,
nothing,
no, seriously.
And once again, I am cucked of a last origin announcement. Give me a last origin figure, damn it.
Yeah, no, this was probably the most anemic one we've had for a while. I was a little bit disappointed because I was like, oh shit, how the fuck am I going to get a podcast? How the fuck are we going to get podcasts out of this? But we managed.
The last one we had, I think there were more Nendoroids alone than there were this entire announcement.
Yeah, it's not great.
On the other hand, at least there was only like 8 placards this time.
Yeah, I mean, but placards are nice because you get announcements and stuff, even though you don't get an actual prototype. So
or it's... even an app release date or anything, just like, hey, it's happening one day, maybe.
I was hoping we'd get an act mode Carol from Symphogear GX, but I wasn't actually expecting that to happen, but
yeah,
it is what it is. We at least, maybe they'll do it, maybe they'll announce more after we get, you know, Shirabi and Kirika coming out. Because yes. they did wait until, like, the OG trio was nearly out before announcing the other three.
Yeah, I do kind of feel that maybe if we did this, like, bi-monthly instead of, like, every season, we might have a bit more content.
Yeah, I was about to say, because we missed, there was the Shizuoka hobby show for model kits that we completely missed out on because that was just in between events, and like there's enough of stuff that comes out monthly that we could do a podcast about it, but I'm gonna leave that up to you guys if you guys are down for it or not. I'll talk to you about it later.
Need to work out the schedules for it.
Yeah, like, you know, end of month thing and all that, that'd be nice. Yeah. But I'd have to compilate, like, all the news, because, you know, there's a lot that does come out.
Yeah.
So.
Warthog says, personally, I want to see the Ignite Gears, but Carol would be dope.
See, the Ignite Gears would be nice, but I want characters that haven't been done. I would like to see the Alchemist Trio get figures. I would like to see Carol get a figure. I would like to see the Honorscorers getting figure. I would like to see Noble Red get figures.
You got the fact that, nope. I still can't believe that Kaneko used so much shit from Wild Arms 4 specifically when writing Symphogear, because Noble Red comes from Wild Arms.
Yeah, you've mentioned that before. It's funny. But yeah, it was an anemic event. I feel like next time we do a thing, we might, hopefully it won't be anemic, and, you know, maybe we'll do a bi-monthly thing. I don't know. We'll work out the schedule for that.
Shorter, that'd be fine.
Yeah, shorter, like, hour-long, two-hour podcasts aren't bad, but, like, considering I feel like I hyped this one up, I'm a little bit disappointed.
Cause I mean, there's not much to do when it's supposed to be a big event, and then it's, like, nothing.
Yeah, we the last few were huge, so I figured, oh, it's probably gonna be a big one again, but, like, nope. So, that's why I kind of tacked on the Tamashii thing, and then, like, going for the, like, some of the other stuff on there.
Yeah,
but as far it's a shame that Tech dipped out when they did because I was like, hey, do some self-promotion, but no. What are you doing? Let's do some self-promotion.
Aside from work, tomorrow and Tuesday, I'm currently playing through Dragon Quest Monsters Joker, all three games, because they announced a new Dragon Quest Monsters game wasn't in development for the Switch.
And if you don't know what Dragon Quest Monsters is, it's basically Dragon Quest but Pokemon.
It actually predates Pokemon.
Oh. Wow.
Sort of. Dragon Quest V specifically had a monster catch mechanic where you could have a party member be a monster character. And you could swap them out as you wished. And that was made into a full-ass game. I think that game predates Pokemon by like a few weeks.
Mm. So
I think it's a lot more interestingly too, because instead of like throwing the
ball to force them to be your slaves.
that's one way to put it.
In Dragon Quest Monsters, originally, you had to make them trust you by giving them meat.
Ah. But that's what Kata's going to be doing for the next week or however long. I don't know how long those games are.
Dragon Quest Monsters are usually really short.
So, for my stuff next week, I don't know if I'm going to do a model kit next week or not. I have plenty of stuff I've been backlog. I'm just not sure what I want to do or what people would be interested in me seeing me do. I'd say I put a poll on Twitter, but like Twitter got rid of polls for fucking normies, so fuck you, Elon Musk.
Thank you, elongated muskrat.
I love how everyone just has resulted on that for his name now. Elongated muskrat. But I will figure out something to do for Friday's stream. Wednesday CV. So ACV will not be my next Armored Core game I'm just going to stream. I feel like I should do justice to Armored Core 4 Answer, since it is my favorite entry into the franchise next to Armored Core 4. So my next stream for Armored Core for video games will be Armored Core 4 Answer. But then after that is Armored Core 5.
And then after that
is Verdict Day. 4th,
no, I was going to say on July 4th, they're going to do Metal Wolf Chaos, because of course you have to.
Well, what day is that? Is that a Monday? Is that a Friday? What day is that?
Tuesday.
Oh, I'm from where I work that night.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a weekday.
You don't have holidays?
No.
Ah, rip.
I'm considered an essential worker, so I don't really get holidays off. I get holiday pay now for a decent amount of holidays, but yeah, the next video game stream will not be this next weekend because I'm working that Sunday, but the next Sunday after that will be Armored Core 4 Answer at 10 p.m. Eastern, and then after that will be Armored Core 5. I should be able to get through Armored Core 4 Answer in either one or two sessions, so it's not a very long game. Armored Core 5 will be an interesting thing, because I don't know how long that's going to take for me, because I have played Armored Core 5 once through its campaign, and then fucking never touched it again, because Armored Core 5 is not one of the game I like. And then after that will be Verdict Day. Hopefully I can get those done before Armored Core 6 drops, but
When is Armored Core 6?
It is August 25th, and I took that day off so I can play it and stream it, so you guys will see me play that game, at least my first impressions of it. I don't know if I'm going to do full playthrough of it on stream, because I do want to just play it on my own, but yeah. But next week's streams will be what I figure it out as we go along. I might do 2 model kit streams, I might do just a Friday stream, I might not even stream at all, I don't know, it's all in flux, as it is. But
Aeon Flux.
God, I should play the Aeon Flux PS2 game on stream, because I've never played that.
For it.
Yeah, apparently the PS2 game is very good.
Yeah, with PS2 licensed games, as always, was a coin flip. So
yeah,
like I have fond memories of the fucking Chronicles of Narnia game.
I didn't even know they made one.
Of course they did. They made a movie for everything back then.
Yeah, you're right. I'm just like, I just completely forgot about that. But yeah, that's this tentative screen schedule. We might do more figure streams later on next month, depending on how much news there is bi-monthly. But yeah, I want to thank Kata for joining me on this. Plug your socials. I know you plugged your streams. I wasn't sure about if you plugged your Twitter.
My Twitter is just Kata-kun. I retweet a lot of almost porn, so
yeah, basically.
I avoid actually directly plugging it.
Oh, that's fair. You already know my socials. It's linked below in the Twitch thing. I want to thank you all for stopping by and indulging us in this anemic podcast, but it is what it is. Our wallets were not horrendously banged up this time.
Yeah, their mine wallet is hurting for other reasons, but not because of this, at least.
Yeah, thankfully. So, yeah. Jim, I hope you enjoy your drink. And again, thank you all for stopping by. I will see you guys next week. Adios. Thank you.